As you know, hundreds of people are injured by police brutality every year. Dozens of people are murdered by police brutality every single year, even here in Dallas, where the police are so nice to everyone else, as we know. I know all you Occupy people learned how nice the police can be to the people off sidewalk. Alright, we're about to march down Main Street. We're going to turn right on Lamar. Everyone, just follow the banner. We're going to march right to DPD headquarters, and we're going to hear from some speakers, alright? Alright, let's go.
got some, but it's not as good as it could be. They're honking at us.
We got the
dentals. A certain element of society can appreciate that. Okay, let me swing the... Go ahead, I'm going to swing the entire cop brigade here. The lady with the ticket book on the clipboard. Only if they got my favorite beer. Parked underneath the courthouse. I'm gonna use a train to get to GA.
Fight back!
What do we do?
Fight back!
What do we do?
Fight back! The Dallas Brown Beret are here today to tell our communities that we stand with you. We will no longer be taking this type of police brutality in our neighborhoods to any people.
Movement and the African Socialist International is in solidarity with what the simple fact that I say you call it, people call it racism when people are being persecuted. And, you know, and I'm seeing now that that police brutality, police terrorism don't know color lines. So so what I'm here to say is that we face a different oppression than certain people would, you know, just for standing up. We are, there's a lot of corruption in the community, and there is a lot of police containment we have in the community. And the reason being that there's no... Can you hear me? And the reason why y'all may not agree with a lot of things I say, but faces same persecution, same oppression, you know, police containment and corruption, with the police who are criminals who would steal, who would go in the African community, the community where I live in South Dallas, or any community, and they do shakedowns because there's no economic development there, drug economy. It's all kind of corruption that's going on within the community that y'all may not see. But I let y'all know that this is what's happening in our community. And that's why I organized the International Disability Movement to win democratic rights for African people. And to the simple fact that the capitalist economy is based on the fact that slave, and that's how the America came to exist. And it wouldn't have existed without us, without the labor or any other labor, Asian labor or the Mexican labor, any other labor that makes the capitalist society here today. But I'm not going to exclude everyone else. But we face the blood of police brutality. So we've been labeled as criminals. So in fact, oh yeah, we need police terrorism. We need police to terrorize them to stop the drugs, stop gang and all that. But it is a consequence. As a consequence of a movement that they tried to suppress back in the 1960s, and once they destroyed that, they continued to do it with the drug economy, which brought drugs in the African community to stop the Black Power movement. And I'll let you know that we're still here, and we're still alive, and we're still moving, and we're going to continue with the struggle with the African liberation, and we want a united socialist Africa, and we want the united African people. We want the oppressed people of the world to know, the Palestinians and anyone who is struggling for the liberation struggle, who are being oppressed all over the world, that we are there for you and we're in solidarity with you and we will work with you. As a matter of fact, we do have a African People Solidarity Committee, which is led by the African People Socialist Party for that purpose, to say victory, to bring victory to the oppressed people of the world. So I say victory to the oppressed people of Palestine, victory to the oppressed people of Europe, victory to the oppressed people in China, victory to the oppressed people in Europe, victory to all oppressed people all over the world, because we're not an isolated organization. And we just want you to know that that we're here, and I'm moving with you, united. Yahoo!
Yahoo means freedom for all of you who didn't know that.
Oh, sorry, yeah. Yeah, that too.
I'd like to introduce Mr. David Harding from the Workers International League.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Fuck the police.
This isn't the place to have this conversation.
Dan.
Can you wait until after the demonstration?
Dan.
Lenin said that a standing army and the police are the chief instruments of state power. That's how they oppress people, that's how they oppress the workers, that's how they oppress the poor, that's how they oppress the propertyless, the people who have to work 16 to 20 hours a day. You guys don't even fucking do anything. You don't even have real jobs. What are your jobs? Standing there. Get a real job. What do I do out in a restaurant? What do y'all do? Y'all have real jobs, right? Or if you don't, you need one to make a wage. This is going to get paid by our fucking families and all the working people in this whole country. They pay their taxes. They give them weapons. They give them tricycles. They give them whatever the fuck car that is. I don't even know. Look, man, Police brutality can happen anywhere. It can happen in any country to anyone. Brutality is part of the police system. It is individualized terror to repress us, our families, and ultimately the entire working class. They want to make us weak, to break us psychologically so that we will always submit to the ruling class. The government is a capitalist government and defends the interests of capitalists.
Boo.
The harassment, abuse, and terror that we see by our own government, by the police, by this police department, by these individuals right here, every time they pull someone over who's on their way to work just to give them a fucking ticket, and that's if you're lucky, if they don't pull you over and rape you, beat you, or fucking tase you, right? It's the same that we see abroad in Iraq, Afghanistan, and the countries that we've already invaded, and the countries that you don't know that we've invaded because we've got secret agents there, right? The CIA and whatnot. It has the same root cause. It is the capitalists who want to profit, that promote these individuals and wars, and set up these police departments. But we live in a revolutionary time. Over the past 100 or so years, workers have risen up and made their own governments. We don't need police. We can have the people armed. That is what Karl Marx, that is what Lenin has called for, that is what communists called for, and that's what I think all working people need to recognize is needed. We don't need the police. The police need us to pay taxes so they can keep us. And then say, well, we're here to help you.
Protect and serve my ass!
That's right. The Paris Commune of 1871, the St. Louis Strike Committee of the Great Rail Strike of 1877, the example of the Seattle General Strike of 1919, the Russian Revolution in 1905 and in 1917, and in 1905 also in Lithuania and in Poland. They all show that we do not need the police. We do not need the police of the capitalists. We can arrange our own affairs. We can arrange our own safety in our own communities. The best way to do that is to get a gun, learn how to shoot, set up armed committees of workers based on the workplace, based on the trade unions. And if you're not in a trade union, contact the trade union, organize at your workplace. Because what we need is workers' militias, okay? That's what we need. We don't need the police. There is another way for them to. I'm almost done here. This is what the police can do for us, because I know you guys, you know, you just got a job. The police are actually like us in one way, only one way. They are proletarian. They have nothing to sell but their labor power. They have to sell their labor power in exchange for a wage. They need that wage in order to support their families. Right? Is that right? They're not even listening because they're fucking retarded. So, this is what the police can do. Yeah, exactly. Release all political prisoners, all drug crime prisoners, all prisoners whose sentences have been affected by racist police. That's basically all police. Courts or other idiots. Release all prisoners arrested for illegal immigration. The police need to go on strike. They need to throw down their badges. They need to pick up the red flag. They need to hand over all of their weapons to the common working people. The police need to disarm. The police need to disband. The police need to investigate. They need to be investigated, and they need to be arrested. I'm the secretary of the Dallas-Fort Worth branch of the Workers' International League. We publish Socialist Appeal. I have some for sale. Thank you.
Woo!
America! How do you find the gun? Police department!
Guilty!
How do you find them?
Guilty!
How do you find them?
Guilty!
Night.
here scenario. October 29th, 2010, an officer by the name of
out of battery. Okay, I'm going to switch over to the phone. The camera on the phone, I'm running out of battery.